And in regular blob tag, if I tag somebody with a noodle, we join together, whether it's joining hands, power grip, or interlocking elbows. I always love giving my kids choices. That's going to be a theme that that you'll hear throughout both sessions. I love giving them choices. So if boys don't want to hold hands, we say power grip. So it's like I lock in with somebody's forearm like this. All right, that's a power grip. Obviously, the best way to be effective in moving quickly is joining hands. So in this game, reverse blob tag, you start off with a big ball. Regular blob tag, which is a really fun instant activity with no equipment other than noodles. I'm the only tagger. I tag somebody, they join my blob, we tag somebody. Our blob gets progressively bigger. In reverse blob tag, Omnicus style, you start in a big blob. So you're going to start about 6 to 8. So we got a big group of 8 right here. We got about 6 or 7 here, 6 or 7 there. If you get tagged with the ball, anybody in your blob gets tagged with the ball, you have to divide in half. All right? So the objective is to have the biggest blob at the end of the round. Make sense? So you're going to move around and try to avoid me. And our RPM is going to go all the way over to where the carpet changes color. And all the way to the wall there, all the way to the chairs there. Does that make sense? Your blob is the blob that you start with. No joining blobs. But again, if you've got a way that you can modify it to make it better, feel free to do that. Okay? So join together with your blobs.
Let's check you with a unit long.
3, 6, 7. You have some problem solving to do if I hit you. You got 7. Yes, I would start away from the ball. I would start the ball right here. I got the ball. Teacher has the ball.
Those are blobs.